गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू ऑफलाइन क्लास। एस्टरडेज वी डिस्कस्ड फ्रेंड्स ऑफ द ट्रीज रिविजन क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अंडरस्टैंडिंग द टेक्स्ट ऑफ फ्रेंड्स ऑफ द ट्री, लेसन पेज नंबर 39। द वुडपेकर सेटल्ड ऑन द फुट ऑफ द ट्री। The woodpecker settled on the foot of the tree as he was a little tired. Answer is as he was little tired. The beetles were not going to ask the bees anything because they were not interested in gathering nectar. Second one answer is C. Third one, the beetles asked the woodpecker to sing because they wished to distract the mind of woodpecker. Answer is B. When the tree mourned, the beetles threatened the tree about eating it up soon. They are giving warning to the tree that we are going to eat you up. Will going to destroy. Next, page number 40. Understanding words, prefixes and suffixes. I told already in regular class. Prefixes means adding before the main word. Suffixes means adding after the main word. Prefixes are a group of letters added at the beginning of the word. At the beginning of the word, prefixes add to the main word, as he told in the page number 40. Beginning of the letter, these prefixes add to the main word. Some prefixes, when added to words, form new words that are opposite in meaning. For example, if we add some words to the main word at the beginning, we get opposite word, antonyms. Opposite word, another name, antonyms. Synonyms, meanings, antonyms, opposite words. In the story, beetles find a new home in the bark of the tree to be quite comfortable. Quite comfortable, but this causes discomfort to the tree. This causes comfort and discomfort. To the tree. The woodpecker helps his friend to save him from the uncomfortable situation. Comfortable opposite uncomfortable, and comfort. Comfortable opposite uncomfortable situation. These are the words dis and un are prefixes. Dis and un are prefixes. These prefixes add to the main word at the beginning of the word. Prefixes such as un, in, dis and miss, im are often used to form opposites. These are the main prefixes to make the antonyms, I mean opposites. If you add these words to the main word, immediately we'll get opposites. Opposite meaning we would get. Using the above mentioned prefixes from prefixes form opposites to the words in brackets and complete the sentence. The task looked dire when we first began to work. Bracket possible is there, page number 40. Possible opposite. What is the possible opposite? Which type of prefixes you have to use this possible main word before at the beginning? Which word is suitable for opposite word of possible? Impossible or dispossible? miss possible or impossible. Obviously, im is suitable to make opposite in meaning for possible. The story sounded dash, but Kritika said that it was how it exactly happened. Believable, believable opposite, unbelievable, 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 believable is main word. We have to add an at the beginning of believable, so we could get opposite word of believable. Unbelievable is opposite word of believable. He dares purchase words and ended up going to the theater room instead of the auditorium. Understood. Understood is main word. If you add misunderstood, that is opposite word of the understood. The internet has been dash connected is there in bracket. You have to write disconnected, connected and disconnected. Ritesh seems to be behaved rather fairly opposite unfairly with Satish these days. Unfairly, fairly opposite is unfairly. I know for a fact that Arpita dash tomatoes tomatoes. See here likes dislikes. It is dash hot for a winter day. Usual opposite unusual. These are the A Roman. You have to write properly in your textbook. Page number 41. I could not find Rahil in the crowd. I thought she had become dash visible. Visible opposite is invisible. Visible opposite is invisible. The story of the fire seems to have been dash in this newspaper. Misrepresented is correct answer for answer in the sense opposite for miss for represented opposite word is misrepresented. You have to understand represented opposite is misrepresented. Look at these words: rewrite, redo. Here the suffixes re when added to words suggest a repetition of the action that the word shows. That is, when we say rewrite, we mean write something again, not opposite word. You have to remember. When we say redo, we mean do something again. The all prefixes not opposite words. There are some prefixes. If you add some prefixes to them, you have to see here. Prefixes to the verb. Write is verb. If you add rewrite. This is prefix. This means do the read again. That means read again. Do is verb. Redo is prefix. That means you have to do the work again. If you it is not to understand that all prefixes are giving opposite words. If you add prefixes to the any word, it is not opposite word. There are some exceptional cases. You have to understand. Complete these sentences using the words from the box: refill, recall, rejoin, restart, and replan. These are five sentences he had given. We had to dash our whole strategy. We have to replan our whole strategy. the first strategy what we have done, it was failed. So we have to rethink. Tarun went to dash his bottle. First he filled the bottle and he drank the water. Again he went for refilling. In another case, the first bottle what he had filled, the bottle was dirty. That's why he went to the tap to fill again. Dash the device to complete the updates. Restart. If you start, first you have started, but you could not do all the options on hand. So you need to restart the system or mobile. Sanya decided to rejoin the dramatic club. She had joined, but again she wanted to join. They could not recall his name, however hard they tried. See, in these five sentences, if you observe carefully, plan is well, fill is well, start is well, join is well, call is well. If you add anything to the verb, anything in the sense, if you add prefixes to the verbs, it says that after observing these five words, five sentences, we could easily understand that we have to do the work again. We have to do the things again. We have to start the computer, or we have to recollect. If you could not remember his name, you have to try his name twice or thrice. That is called recalling. Next, rejoin again. That girl is, that boy is joining in the dramatic club. Next, page number 41, understanding rules. In the story, the Beatles have to be alert for their worst enemy. Bad was worst. Bad was worst. Worst enemy. Bad. Worst. This is positive degree, this is comparative degree, this is superlative degree. See here, in the story, the Beatles have to be alert for their worst enemy. Worst enemy, see, this is superlative degree. Worst and worst. Bad was worst. This is superlative degree. Worst is superlative degree. Worst enemy. See, the woodpecker was the worst enemy to the Beatles. As you have learned, worst here is an adjective. Adjective. Worst shows the degrees of how bad a thing or person is. Some adjective change forms while showing different degrees. See, this adjective worst shows that superlative degree, and there was no other enemy like the woodpecker. The woodpecker was the worst enemy among all creatures, among all birds. Family, woodpecker was the worst enemy to the Beatles. See here, change the forms, read the sentence and to understand how degrees of comparison work. He is a bad boy. Positive degree tells us of the quality. We are that boy is bad. I told already, he is bad boy. Ram is worse than sham compared to degree makes comparison between two people or two things. If you want to compare two people or two things, was and them compulsory in the comparative degree. The woodpecker was the worst enemy of the beetles. Superlative degree make comparison between three or more people or things. If you compare three or more people, she is the best student. She is the best student in the class. She is the best student. Best student in the class. She is the best student in the class. This is which degree it is? This is by seeing the best, you could understand that this is superlative degree. See, this is superlative degree. There is a comparison. There is a comparison, not one person. Comparison in the class. That means more than two. More than two in class. 35 students maybe in the class. There is a comparison between more than three members in the class. She is the best student in the class. Next, Geeta is better than Sip. This is by seeing better, and then you could understand that this is comparative degree. Next, Geeta is better than Sita. Next, Tanu is good student. Tanu is good by seeing good. You could understand this is superlative degree is best. Good, better, best. This is the degrees of comparison. See, Tanu is good student. Geeta is better than Sita. She is the best student in the class. This is the comparison between three degrees. Tanu is good student. There is no comparison in positive degree. There is no comparison. Like Tanu, many students are in the class as like as Tanu. They are also good students. I am not comparing anyone in positive degree. I am talking about only one girl. That girl is good. Here, Geeta and Sita also in the class. Tanu, Geeta and Sita, and she is also in the same class. Tanu is good student. Geeta is better than Sita. Here I am comparing two, Geeta and Sita. In comparative degree, mostly we will use two persons in comparative degree. And by seeing that, you can easily identify that is comparative degree. And in every comparative degree, than is compulsory. By seeing than, you can understand that is comparative degree. Most important clue is better. If you know the forms good, better, best, next bad, worst, worst, next rich, richer, richest. The if you understand, if you by heart these words, by heart these words, these adjectives, you could easily identify the comparative degree, positive degree, and superlative degree. Here there is a comparison between two. Here she is the best student in the class. She is the best student. We cannot compare like we cannot compare with her because she is the best student in the class. Not only studies, games, discipline, every area she is perfect. She is perfect. So we can call that girl is she is the best student in the class. She is best student in the class. By seeing that, you can understand positive comparative superlative degrees are known as the degrees of comparison. Positive degree, comparative degree, superlative degree, we can call degrees of comparison. This is only degrees of comparison. Degrees of positive degree, I mean positive degree, comparative degree, superlative degree. There are some examples, total 4 models are there. When you come to 6th class, we will discuss degrees of comparison. In general, an adjective can be changed from its positive degree into its comparative degree by adding the suffix -er and into its superlative degree by adding the suffix -est. Suffixes and prefixes we discussed, and suffixes, what are the suffixes? Bad, worse, and worst. If you add suffixes, see these suffixes, if you add se to the word, these are irregular adjectives. These are irregular adjectives. Bad, worse, worst. Ill, worse, worst. Good, better, best. These are irregular adjectives. Irregular adjectives doesn't follow the rules. Irregular adjectives doesn't follow the rules. Only regular adjectives follow the rules. That means richest. This is superlative degree. Here est is added. Here er is added. This is comparative degree. In these 3 degrees, rich is common. Rich is common. There is a rule that we have to add er in comparative degree, est in superlative degree. Here also superlative degree in comparative degree, er is not added. Here est is added. But in 3, here bad is there, here worst, and here worst. In 3 degrees, this word should repeat. This word should repeat, and er and est should be in the comparative and superlative degree. So if you see this, if the degrees follows these rules, we can say that is regular adjective. This is regular adjective. This is irregular adjective. Irregular adjective. And good, better, best also. Good is positive degree, and better, it is changed. Here is there, but good is not coming in comparative degree and superlative degree. You have to understand that. See, children, this is comparative degree. You have to by heart more degrees of comparison: good, better, best, well, better, best, and rich, richer, richest. Next, and another one also there. That is beautiful, more beautiful, and most beautiful. That is also regular adjective. It follows the follows rules, that is beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. Sir, how can we differentiate where we have to use ER and where we have to use EST? You can easily identify rich, we can pronounce at a time. If there are two or more than two syllables in one word, you have to use more and more in comparative degree, most in superlative degree. See, beautiful. There are three syllables in this beautiful word. If you find more than two syllables in in the word, you have to use more beautiful and most beautiful. Handsome, more handsome, most handsome. This is the case, that is also comes under regular adjective. Irregular adjectives doesn't follow any rule. You have to see that carefully. Next, EST, positive degree, comparative degree, superlative degree, page number 42. Positive degree warm, warmer, superlative degree warmest. Next, nice, nicer, nicest. Great, greater, greatest. These are regular adjectives. These are regular adjectives because at the end ER is added, superlative degree EST is added. ER is added and EST is added. ST is added. See, complete these sentences using the correct form of adjectives in the brackets. India is the second largest population in the world. Largest. Which degree is that? Which degree? See, as I told, second, first, 21st century, 100th century, 10th century, 11th century, odd numbers before, the we must use. See, the second largest population, the second, the first, the third, the fourth, when you use ordinal numbers, you have to use the before ordinal numbers. It is very cold in December. So which degree is this? Does it belongs to positive degree or comparative degree? It is positive degree. Cold, colder, oldest. Next, Abhinav was the earliest to arrive the class. The earliest is which degree? Superlative degree. Sneha is older than. If you find than or older, you can easily identify that is which degree? Comparative degree. Dorothy thinks plums are tastier than grapes. Tastier than which degree? Comparative degree. Cycling is considered to be one of the healthiest. If you see the, you can, before superlative degree, you can easily identify that is superlative degree. Next, Simran is taller than Pooja. Taller than comparative degree. She seems to be smarter than us all. If you find out, then you can easily identify that is comparative degree. Smartest. She seems to be smarter than us all. Smartest. Not only adjectives. Adverbs also have the degrees. That is fast. Fast is adjective. Adverb. Fast is adverb. Fast is adverb. Fast, faster, fastest. Quick, quicker, quickest. These are the adverbs. There are more adverbs comes under degrees of comparison, not only adjectives. Children, I hope you have understood this textbook exercise. Friends of the is read well. If you have any doubt, send through WhatsApp. I will answer your doubts. Thank you. Have a good day.